On Saturday, the 28th November 2015, Kasturi and Sons have launched the first edition of The Hindu in Mumbai. Already, this newspaper is published from 17 major cities across India, which makes the Mumbai edition now its 41st. So here's a paper that has traditionally had a stronghold in the southern markets. In Mumbai, of course, it's going to face some stiff competition to get its share of readers. It goes head-to-head against the Times of India, Hindustan Times, DNA, the Indian Express, Asian Age, even tabloids like Mumbai Mirror and Midday. So how are advertisers looking at this debut, given that Mumbai is India's largest advertising market? We've spoken to a cross-section and we've read between their lines as well in this, which is our top story of the week.
The Hindu is India's third largest read English daily and has arguably created a niche for itself as a conservative, intellectual and long-format English broadsheet over the past 137 years. But traditionally, its strongest markets have been in the southern states where it has a loyal readership base. While it has a pan-India presence as well, including a Delhi edition, it has chosen to stay away from the more fast-paced Mumbai market. So why did the decision to launch a Mumbai edition come about now?
In the early 1950s, there was an idea, back-of-the-mind idea, to start a Mumbai edition, but for various historical reasons, it couldn't be done, wasn't done at that time, or couldn't be done. But I think it's overdue that because others have entered, the Times of India is way in ahead, the number one player here, but others have entered the market, and I think we have something to contribute in terms of trustworthy journalism, relevant journalism, and fairly comprehensive coverage, and also a forward-looking outlook. So I think we have a place here, and I mean, it would be surprising if we didn't enter at some point. It's taken a long while, but this is a good time to enter because we are now on a growth path. We had a couple of difficult years, but we now are clearly on a growth path, both in a business sense and also editorially.
The Hindu's entry into the Mumbai market this week marks a turning point for print media here. But this entry has been fairly discreet. In sharp contrast, the last big launch of an English newspaper in Mumbai was the Daily News and Analysis, or DNA, which was launched in 2005 amidst much fanfare and an estimated expense of Rs. 100 crores. So is Hindu's low-profile advertising enough to really make an impact?
Perhaps keeping in line with Hindu's understated positioning, I would think it was a bit understated. I don't think it was as impactful as it could have been, particularly because it's a launch that you're doing in a new market. I was particularly disappointed about their out-of-home. Usually out-of-home is a very important medium for the newspaper. And while one did see some of it, it wasn't impactful at all. Digital needs to be used in a big way because today the readers are becoming digital. So I would say it could have been handled much better, but then I can understand the tone of the communication because that's a part of the personality of the Hindu.
Print advertising in India is a 16,875 crore industry, accounting for 34.5% of the total advertising market, which stands at 48,976 crores. Mumbai, where the Hindu has just set foot, is also the largest print advertising market in the country. So how are advertisers and media planners viewing this latest entrant?
Better late than never is all I'll say. The people enjoy it. So it's a great product. I still believe it's a great product, but the fact that they have come in, it's a very good opening. I can only repeat, better late than never. There's a core English audience you'll find everywhere, whether they're followers of those experience the product in Tamil Nadu or not, it works for them.
Well, I think it's an interesting development that we have the Hindu finally coming into Mumbai. I think it's firstly for advertisers and media planners, it's great news whenever there are more options, more media formats, channels available in markets. And especially for a market like Mumbai, which is obviously a very big market for most media plans, it just gives us additional opportunity. The Hindu, of course, has got an extremely credible lineage, and we've been waiting for this for years. And knowing the Times Group, I'm sure they're going to take this in their stride, but do whatever it takes to stay number one, it's another fantastic brand. So yeah, I think all in all it's good news. I think it's a win-win for all concerned, for advertisers, for readers, and I think the existing brands would also emerge stronger.
For The Hindu, while entering the Mumbai market is a milestone, how does it plan to localize its content to stand out from its competitors and really give its readers a differentiated offering?
It'll be very different. There'll be special coverage of Mumbai, at least 8 pages, different because Mumbai has distinctive characteristics, not only as a financial capital, but it's a very cosmopolitan place, despite some forces trying to impose their narrow agendas here. So I think Mumbai has this is a great city, and it was not for nothing that it was labeled a maximum city. So everything is maximum here, and I think we have to devote special attention to it. So it'll be different from our Delhi edition. It'll be different from our Chennai edition, which has our strongest edition. But we have something to contribute here.
Now, The Hindu's entry into Mumbai could certainly shake things up for the print media here. But its advantage readers, they get a wider range of mastheads and content to wake up to each morning. But whether or not The Hindu's entry into the commercial capital of India pays off for them is a space we'll be watching very closely. We take a short break now. On the other side, we speak to R.S. Kalsi, the Executive Director of Marketing and Sales at India's largest car maker, Maruti Suzuki. How's their Nexa bet working out? We'll ask him. Do stay with us.